March 10th was on a Monday. I didn't feel, I woke up okay and I thought, okay, I'm feeling good. And I went on my journey to go to work and still had the numbness, still had the pain in my eye and the blurriness. I needed answers, so I called my doctor. Couldn't make an appointment until Wednesday. So I said, okay, I think I could make it. I mean, they did a CAT scan. Everything's fine, right? I dealt with it and just kept on going. That Wednesday when I went to the doctor, of course, he was kind of upset that I had left the Coumadin a year ago because I haven't been there like in 2 years. I've been fine. And he was like, wow, you haven't been here for a while. I was like, well, if I'm good, why am I going to come see you? But when he checked this eye, the pupil was bigger than this one. And when he would put the light, it would take longer to get smaller, like normal. And he, you know, with what I was telling him, he was afraid that because I left the Coumadin, it had done some brain damage or something. So he wanted an MRI, and he wanted it as stat. So he put me on stat. He says, you gotta go. He was trying to get me to do the MRI there. But of course, no coverage. They didn't want to hear it. They wouldn't even go on a payment plan with me. So he told me, go to the emergency room. Nelly goes again to the emergency room. And I had the worst experience in my life. I'm telling you, that girl on the desk, she lucky I wasn't feeling good. Not that I'm violent, but I would really report her. And when I get a little better that I can, I am going to make a report. She treated me very, very, very unprofessional. I wasn't feeling well. And anyway, getting away from that. After that, they did another CAT scan with contrast this time. Off again because I don't have no coverage. Thursday, I go to work. I push myself. I'm not feeling well. I'm off balance. My left side is weak. I'm tired, exhausted, but I push myself because that's what I do. I push myself. And I went to work after work. You know, I called my doctor and told him, look, I'm not feeling well. This is just not me. Something's wrong. He's like, you're going to have to go back to the emergency room. So off I go. Now, this is the third emergency room that I go to. I went to another one that's closer to my job. Again, they were no coverage. They were ready to sign me off. And I was like, all I want you to tell me is why you can't do this MRI. My doctor, I said, I'm not a doctor, but my doctor wants me to get this MRI. Why? You know, like, help me. I need your help. And I begged her. I said, please, I just need help. I need to find out what's going on. Something's wrong. She did what she could. I said, do me a favor. Please call my doctor. Let him explain to you. So she called. She got me admitted. And they left me. They did an MRI. Everything, thank God, no tumor. And everything is good in that aspect. I still don't know what's going on. And it's getting worse. Now I can't, it's hard for me to write with my left hand. I'm a lefty. And walking some moments, I can't function right. And then it goes back. So something definitely is wrong. Next step is they want me to go to a neurologist, you know. So that will be my next step, which I'm waiting today to hopefully get an appointment. I'll keep you posted. Thank you for listening and being here with me.